Well, you know, we're back again here. It's Sunday, January 10th, the new year, and we got a lot on our mind right now. We're at the spits of truth, dude. You know, like, we're at some shit that's happened. We got to kick some shit out today.
Yeah, we've been brought to the thought of the ridicule and the things that could occur because of what we do.
It's ridiculous, you know, like we're taking, like, you know, remember we talked in the other videos about the ridicule from our own families, like it says a prophet is without honor in his own town and his own family, you know, and that's very true, you know, like, you know, I just got done dealing with my mom, you know, now she takes this as like, it's like, you got crazy, this is crazy stuff, you know, you can't talk to the Christ and Buddha, you know, like, it's obviously, you know, that they can come through just like anyone else. People pray to them all day.
Yeah, they pray on their knees, they talk to them, and they speak to them, and they expect to be heard. If a medium can see somebody, why couldn't I see any entity, you know, from the past, the time now, you know, like I always say Hendrix, Jimi Hendrix, Shakespeare, a Civil War guy, a friend's mom, or a thug, or the Buddha, or the Christ, they're all people, they're all able to come through.
That's right.
You know.
And they do.
And they do. I mean, that's all we can say. We're not crazy.
Yeah. I mean, we know we're not crazy. Don't get us wrong, but, like, it's irritating when your own family is trying, like, as both of us, like, writes us off as like that, you know, because it's like they can't accept us, like, you know, my family, like, they always knew from the time I was a kid, I was like, look, I want to help people, this is what I'm going to do, my life is my job, to help people.
Yeah.
And we're helping, me and Jeremy too, when we're helping people, yeah. Yet they're like, you know, why can't you just talk about normal things?
Everyday life,
what is everyday life?
We're sons of God.
Yes,
okay.
And you are too,
yeah.
All of you.
As well as you.
Sons and daughters of God, everybody here, from the best to the worst.
Yeah, all walks of life. So, let me say this, you know, I made a statement. There's no hell burning down on the ground with fire and Satan with the tail and the horns.
Yeah.
You know? There's no gate in heaven being signing you in, welcome to heaven, you know, you done well. That's not going on. I mean, I'm sorry.
Hey, I'm sorry to destroy your little delusion of ignorance.
That's not the truth,
yeah, you know?
That's not what's going on. I mean, Jesus was laid back as well as,
this is how I see Jesus. Like, let's tell him about that. Jesus, like, would be, like, in this world today, if Jesus walking around, you know, he'd be hanging out with the gangsters and the thugs.
Yeah.
You know, being down, running through South Central L.A., South Side Chicago, just walking the streets, just chilling with people. He might fire up a blunt, smoke a blunt with somebody. And, you know, I could see him doing that, too.
I mean, why
wouldn't
he?
You know, why wouldn't he?
I mean, because other people put him on a pedestal.
He didn't want that.
I don't think that. He wanted that.
No.
I mean, I know from his mouth, you know.
We heard it direct from him.
Right.
But
what I'm trying to say is, like, if we didn't know, like, if this wasn't happening, we wouldn't be able to do it, one. Two, if we knew we were going to get ridiculed, but at the same time, it's like, if we felt like we were doing something wrong, we wouldn't be doing it.
That's right.
You know, we're trying to help people feel better about their lives, their loved ones, their past loved ones.
That's right.
Any information that we can, I mean, we're just trying to help.
Like today, I was helping people at random. Like, you know, I'm highly in tune psychically and intuitively,
right.
And empathically, extremely, extremely.
Yeah.
You know, and I don't hesitate to tell anybody if the universe is guiding me to say this or that to a certain person, I say it. And I did it today. You know, yeah, I did it today. You know, right in, you know, I was helping people. You know, like you know.
And we know, we got a call. I'm not going to mention any names right now, but we helped two people.
Y'all know who you are.
Yeah, just last night, you know, and you know, the thing was, one wanted to talk to their mother, and we did that. It was accurate. It was
totally accurate.
And it healed this pain, you know. That was all we want to do.
That's it.
You know,
nothing but that. We want to help you all, help everybody.
You know, and if we have to use, you know, like Jesus said, he's being used. You know, he knows you have to use us,
yep.
Or use Jesus. You know, it doesn't matter. But we can't be looked at as crazy. We're not crazy. You know, that's one thing I want to make sure you know, because we're not. You know,
And if y'all are out there feeling feelings like we're feeling too, I want you to know you're not crazy. Yeah. I know that some of that. I know some of y'all watching this. I can feel it psychically right now. You know, some of y'all have feelings like we do.
Yeah.
You know, and like you feel crazy because of what you can see and what you can do. But you're not crazy. You've been given those gifts. You're not the devil. You're not some fucking demon.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, you know, I'm not seeing like images of Frankenstein and the mummy and shit.
Yeah.
You know, I'm not seeing images of delusional things floating around. Fairies and stuff. I'm not seeing that.
And neither am I. How could I help these people? Like, people I don't even know, but I see all this stuff in my mind's eye, and then they start crying and stuff when I tell them because I'm helping them heal. Everything was accurate. I mean, how is that a delusion or a hallucination?
I mean, we can compare it to John Edwards, Sylvia Brown, Jane Fenton Craig,
George Anderson, Edgar Casey. You know, all of them and more. I would say Neil Donald Walsh, he wrote the Conversation with God books.
Yeah.
You know, like, people said he's crazy, hallucinating the words that he wrote, but yet he wasn't.
Brilliant
words, absolutely brilliant. And like that book helped me. You know, I got to give credit
too.
To Neil right here. If you're watching this, Neil, you know it might be. You know, I feel every word you're saying. I'm with you on everything. You know, you're right. You're correct.
Right.
You know, you're changing the world. I want you to know that.
We're not going to be told that we're crazy, and we're not going to be told that you know. That this is not happening, you know.
That's right. You can sell it to us, but it's going to go in one ear and out the other because we know we're not.
Yeah, we're not.
Feel free to say we're crazy, but we're not.
And if you have any, if you have any suggestions as well as to how to deal with this ridicule or our problems like this,
please let us know.
Yeah, because
call us. Write us.
It's not easy. You don't want to feel like you know your family's coming down on you or anybody. We don't want any kind of people saying you know that we're out of whack and crazy or something. You know, when all we're trying to do is help people, you know, we do it in a different way, in a centric way, maybe. In a positive way.
Yeah, but I mean, they call the Buddha eccentric. They call it Christ eccentric.
And he was.
You know, and they were eccentric. You know, we're not comparing ourselves to them, but they, you know.
Yeah.
But then sometimes the brilliant people, like people with who know the truth, sometimes are eccentric.
Well, great minds think alike.
Yeah, that's right.
You know? But
Shakespeare was eccentric. I just thought about him.
I mean, like, you have a slew of dead guitar players, man. Great minds think alike. You know, they're all great guitar players. You know, there's great spiritual teachers in this world. There's great chefs masoneries and
there's great cashiers. I know a woman at PetSmart. If you're watching this, I gave you this address to look this up.
Yeah.
You know who you are. I see you all the time working at the register. Because I remember you talking about that you love your job. You love being the cashier there because you love talking to people and smiling to people and stuff. That's all right. You know, if that's what you feel like doing, you know, if you feel and you love what you do, that's what you should be doing.
Right. And that's all.
Now, this is what we love to do.
This is what we do. I mean.
This is us. This is the real us. We don't hold anything
back.
I got
very like almost standoffish because I felt like, well, you know, well, what have we done wrong?
Nothing.
You know, we've done nothing wrong.
Was helping people wrong? Is loving everybody wrong? It's like sometimes we feel like the world wants us to think it's wrong to love people. I feel it all the time. You know, it's not wrong.
But you know. I don't know what else to say about that situation, but I know that, I guess we're coming out to say that, you know, the bottom line is that we got business to attend to, and we're not crazy.
That's right. We're not crazy. You know, like, I'm getting a cigarette, you know. I don't care what people think of me, you know.
Matt.
Yeah, they're right here. See my mind. See, I was looking at that. Okay.
It's all right.
See, like, there's so much on my mind right now because this stuff is coming together so well. You know, we're stepping into our destinies. You know, here we are. We're helping people. It's my dream to help people. All my life, all I wanted to do was help people, especially younger people. I knew that when I was 4 years old.
Oh, yeah. Young ages, we were
self-aware.
Well, we've talked about this a million times, you know, with all of our life, help people. We've been used, you know, just like the...
But we knew it, and we let it happen.
And just like many other spiritual teachers as well. And I think that, you know, I guess I want to nip this ridicule thing in the bud.
You know, we're going to take ridicule, but fine, okay.
Yeah.
You know, we just wanted to speak on it.
Yeah.
You know, we had a lot to get out, and then I know y'all, so a lot of y'all can relate to the ridicule. I just know it.
And any, but you know, all walks of life can relate to each other, and